officials are the partners of this smart nutrition city program between Pune and Birmingham city. All the NGOs and all like-minded people coming here together for making a good humanity over the world. I would also like to extend my warm welcome to all other dignitaries which are present here. Pune city population is around 4 million people. Migration from rural to urban area has increased as the population seeks better livelihood, as urban areas are offering more and diverse occupational opportunities and increasing educational facilities. Factually, the city of Pune has developed as a counter magnet of Mumbai. 18.5% of the population are in the youths 15 to 24 years age group, and 67% are in the working age group 15 to 59 years of age. Due to urbanization and today's lifestyle, eating habit has been changed a lot. Now you can see a lot of junk foods are coming. Dr. Andrian just told that there are homes which are built without kitchen. And in India, a contrast is there. There is a group of people who are not having kitchen itself from the birth. Or we can say fussy eating has been a common behavioral problem among children, leading to a great amount of stress. Growing children require a lot of energy due to their high activity levels, which in turn require a good intake of healthy nutrients. Along with these kids, every age people require nutritious food to cope up with the rising diseases. Multiple studies have been done on this malnutrition. Few studies show causes of malnutrition in Pune. Now, in Pune, the statistical data shows that nearly 28% of the population is underweight, the age group below 6. And a survey done by the Sathi itself shows that it is not 28, it is more than that. And out of this, the actual statistical figure of the government officials show that more than 10% of the population in Pune, they are malnourished. And out of this, the study which we have done in Pune, if you see the geographical stay of the people living here, 42% of the people, they are living in slums or shanties. And in this, one more study shows that more than 10,000 students, they don't attend the school itself. This is data for them. We are, as a PMC, we are helping them through Rainbow Foundation to build home. Few studies about the malnutrition is about food insecurity, changing diet habits, agricultural production, and changing food environment, obesity. Now in Pune also, the obesity problem in children as well as in population is growing because of all the changing food habits and sedentary lifestyle. If you see the lifestyle, the work itself is just a sedentary, exercise has decreased. So this is also one of the cause why we are getting obesity. There are endocrinal changes which are taking place in males and females at adult age, and because of this also we are getting more patients. Nowadays we can see more patients of hypertension, diabetes or hypothyroidism at early age. As a doctor, as a practicing doctor, I can also see that at early age we are getting coronary artery diseases, which is a red signal for all our humanity. We have several current public health food interventions as the Government of India norms. Its aim is to reduce undernutrition in children under the age of 6, adolescent girls, pregnant and lactating women. Like we are having Anganwadis, self-help groups, midday meal program, and all this we are trying to decrease the malnutrition and undernutrition. As the delegation from Birmingham is visiting hospitals, food stalls, central kitchen, Anganwadi school, FDA and city tour, they will gain on-field experience on the food. With this collaboration, a platform will be created for intercity knowledge exchange and to share the experience on nutrition. All this initiative will build on the existing commitment of both Birmingham and Pune to be smart cities. And ensure that tackling all form of malnutrition becomes a goal which is integrated within this ambition. By working together on these challenges, which take different forms in both cities, both Pune Municipal Corporation and Birmingham City Council will be able to leverage their collective skill and assets and achieve a greater impact than by tackling the problem alone. But this keynote from me, I just want to add one more thing. If you see the disparity between rich and poor in India, the latest data which was shown in 2014, and the survey was done by the University of Zurich, 1% of Indian population, they are having 58.6% of wealth with them, whereas the other are dividing this. So this disparity between urbans and rich and poor, it is increasing in India, and India is the first. Even China and other countries are behind. If you see this malnutrition is major cause because the total per capita income of poor is very less in India. So we have to tackle that. So one concept is the rich people, they eat at hotels, restaurants, and much of the food is wasted. That food which is wasted there in hotels, it has to come in the mainstream. It is just wasted. So in Pune, there is an app which is developed by an NGO, Food Dosti app. This Food Dosti apps, it helps all those restaurants or the hotels where the food is wasted, it is collected and it is divided for the poor. So this is one of the initiative smart activity we can say. With this note, I thank all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for sharing actual statistics and the initiatives taken by PMC.